SpaceX has secured environmental approval from the FAA and relevant federal, state, and local stakeholders to conduct Orbital Starship launches on the South Texas coast. After a relatively normal 12 months of work, and half a dozen poorly communicated delays, the FAA has ultimately issued SpaceX an extremely favorable, mitigated finding of no significant impact. OR mitigated FONSI for its plans to conduct a very limited number of Orbital Starship launches per year out of Boca Chica, Texas. So, when SpaceX launch their first Starship to orbit, let's find out in this video. With the receipt of that final programmatic environmental assessment, SpaceX has arguably hurdled the most difficult regulatory barrier for Texas Orbital Starship launches. SpaceX secured itself a foundation upon which it should be able to attempt to expand the scope of Starbases for long-term utility. To secure that favorable result, however, SpaceX ultimately agreed to dozens upon dozens of mitigations that will take a significant amount of work to complete and maintain in order to partially alleviate some of the launch site's environmental impact. It's also far from the last regulatory hurdle standing between SpaceX and Orbital Starship launches. In many ways, Starbase's final P is a bit simpler than what SpaceX initially requested in its September 2021 draft. As previously discussed, it was already known that SpaceX had withdrawn initial plans to build its own dedicated natural gas power plant, desalination plant, and natural gas refinery, and liquefaction facilities at or near the launch site, before the draft was finalized. The final P goes a bit further, simplifying SpaceX's initial request for two phases of annual Starship launch operations, and settling on a single operational phase that allows up to 5 suborbital and 5 orbital Starship launches per year. However, aside from the already expected removal of on-site methane fuel production and all associated facilities, the rest of the final P appears to be surprisingly close, if not outright identical, to SpaceX's Starbase draft P. Crucially, SpaceX was not forced to reduce the number of permitted orbital launches, suborbital launches, or ship booster static fire tests it originally pursued. While a maximum of 5 orbital launches will severely limit Starbase's utility outside of early flight testing, it's still a big improvement over a compromise for 1-4 annual launches. Perhaps even more notably, the final P also includes permission for up to 500 hours of highway closures for nominal operations, and up to 300 hours of closures for emergency anomaly response per year. Exactly what SpaceX requested in its draft P. In 2014, SpaceX completed an even more thorough environmental impact statement for Falcon rocket launches out of Boca Chica, and received approval for no more than 180 hours of annual closures. A restriction that could have made Starbase virtually unusable as a hub for Starship development. Of the dozens of mitigations SpaceX will have to implement to conduct Starship launches under its new Starbase P, a majority appear to be normal and reasonable. Most focus on specific aspects of things already discussed, like protecting turtles, lighting, beach cleanup, education, nest scouting and monitoring, etc. Safeguarding other protected species, respecting impacted areas of historical importance, ensuring that road closures avoid certain holidays and periods, to limit Starbase's impact on local use of public parks and beaches, and other common sense extensions of existing rules and regulations. In a few cases, SpaceX has even agreed to deploy solar-powered Starlink internet terminals to enable enhanced satellite monitoring of wildlife for the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and Peregrine Fund. Others are oddly specific and read a bit more like local and state agencies taking advantage of their leverage to get SpaceX to manage and pay for basic infrastructure maintenance and improvement that any functional government should already be doing. The lengthy list of odd mitigations. Beach and highway cleanups are done on a quarterly basis. At least one highway wildlife crossing should be built. Building a wildlife viewing station along Highway 4 is a good idea. Complete and maintain traffic control fencing along said public roadway, to demarcate the limits of Texas Parks and Wildlife Department's land. The Texas Parks and Wildlife Department's Fishing Tackle Loaner Program will get $5,000 per year to improve. Prepare a history report on any events and actions related to the Mexican War and Civil War that occurred in all historically significant places. Replicate and install the missing stars and wreaths on the Palmetto Piling's historical marker. Ultimately, the final piece SpaceX received is an extremely positive outcome, and there should be little doubt that SpaceX will complete all mitigations requested of it, and help improve aspects of Boca Chica, Texas as a result. Up next, SpaceX will need to secure an Orbital Starship launch license from the FAA by demonstrating, to the agency's satisfaction, that it meets safety, risk, and financial responsibility requirements, in addition to all environmental requirements. The company has already begun that process with the FAA, but it could still take weeks or months after the final P to secure an operator license or experimental permit. Any such license or permit will be conditional upon the completion of all mitigation requirements established by the P. Regardless, it's now quite likely that SpaceX's Starbase environmental review will finally be complete, freeing up the FAA and SpaceX to focus fully on the launch license side of the equation. Meanwhile, SpaceX still has weeks or even months of work ahead of it to prepare a Starship and Super Heavy pair for their first orbital launch attempt. So, for now, there is no risk of the company being forced to sit around and wait for the gears of bureaucracy to turn. SpaceX engineers are currently performing ground tests of the Starship Super Heavy prototypes that could perform the first ever flight to orbit soon. SpaceX founder Elon Musk shared that teams are already installing 33 Raptor engines, and said the launch vehicle will be stacked again in only a few weeks away. He stated, all Raptor 2 engines needed for first orbital flight are complete and being installed. The company is preparing to conduct the first ever orbital flight test this year, that will enable engineers to speed up the spacecraft's development. SpaceX aims to have a space-ready Starship before the year 2025, when NASA plans to land astronauts on the moon aboard a lunar-optimized Starship, as part of the Artemis program. Becoming multiplanetary is essential to extending dramatically the probable lifespan of civilization and all the forms of life on Earth. SpaceX founder Elon Musk said in February, he hopes that humans can create a sustainable city on the red planet before the year 2050. The SpaceX Starship offers extraordinary potential benefits for the exploration and development of space by both the public and private sectors. It will enable many new commercial space ventures, as well as dramatically lower the costs and raise the frequency of scientific missions that will provide amazing new knowledge about our universe and home planet. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.